Hi everybody, this video is going to be a tutorial of how to make my portrait of a lady album. Originally I was going to do the walkthrough on this video, but the tutorial became so long that I did a separate video. So if you want to see what the book looks like on the inside, there's another video out there. So I'm going to tell you a couple things before I get started on the video or on the tutorial. First of all, at the end of the tutorial you're going to hear me say that I'll show you how to attach the base pages to the hinges. But once I started working, I totally got into it and I did not hit record, and so I did not record myself doing that. However, there are a lot of videos out there to show you how to attach the pages to the hinges, and so if you need to see someone do that, I would suggest you go to Tammy Murrell's page, and she's got a bunch of videos on how to make mini albums. So the other thing I wanted to tell you is that someone had asked me to kind of be specific about what materials you need to make this, because they have never made one and they want to give it a shot, but they don't know what things they need to have. So I'll go through that real quick. So obviously you need a paper pack. For the book I made, which is 7.5 by 9.5, the outside, the inside is 7 by 9 pages. I made 6 pages, so it actually is a pretty big book. You can do less pages, or you can do smaller and adjust the measurements, but I used pretty much a whole 12 by 12 paper pack. I have a little bit left, but not much. I also used a few sheets of 8 by 8, but again, you can probably make it work if you cut carefully and, you know, adjust as needed. So I used this paper. I also had my cardstock as my base. I used a craft color from Country Craft Creations. It did have 25 sheets in it, and I ended up using all of it. I have very little left. So 25 sheets is what it needs, the whole amount. You can get other kind of cardstock, but this, in my opinion, is probably the best. So there's the base papers. You will need chipboard of some sort. This is kind of a medium weight. It's not like a cereal box thickness. It's heavier than that, and that's for the cover. And so you need enough for the front cover, the back cover, and then I had a 3.5 inch spine, so enough chipboard for that. Some of the basic supplies also. I always have a ruler. You obviously need some good scissors, and old Timmy Holtz here has good scissors. I use score tape for the construction of my mini album, putting the book together, the hinges, and putting the base paper on the covers. But for anything else, like the attaching of the designer paper to the base and applying things to the album, I use the Art Glitter Glue. And that's fabulous stuff. It's called Art Glitter Glue. You'll probably need some sort of scoring tool. I have this one. I have another one. I like the Teflon ones, but you can use any kind that you have. I also have this shape too. This just has more coverage, so I like it. And then another thing that you might want to have is a score board. Now, you don't have to. You can just use a paper cutter, or you can use a ruler and some sort of scoring tool. But this makes it easy to measure, so I always use a score pal. Not a score pal. Mine is a Martha Stewart. But there is a brand called Score Pal. And then a paper cutter. So that's kind of the basics. The album, like I said, oh, there's other things I want to show you too real quick. I forgot. For this album, you're going to need some flowers. I used a variety. I just had some in my stash, plus I had this from the store. You're going to need different trims and laces. I use seam binding. You just kind of need a variety of things for the decorating. It's whatever your personal preference and taste is. There were chipboard pieces that come with the collection if you choose to purchase it. And so I have those that I used. If you buy the materials that come with the collection, you can't go wrong. There was a sticker sheet, and I used quite a few of those stickers. A lot of times I end up just mounting them on paper and then cutting them out. Sometimes I use them flat on the paper. But that's the... Oh, I also used the Graphic 45 doorknob for my opening handle, and this came from Country Craft Creations too. but you don't have to use that kind of a closure. I mean, mine doesn't have anything to connect it closed because I made the gussets big enough that it doesn't like fan out, so it can sit up without a problem. So those are kind of the basics as far as the materials go. I always suggest that you watch the video through once to make sure I didn't make any stupid mistakes, which can happen on a regular basis, actually. Every time I make something, you got to make some sort of mistake. That's how you learn, I guess. The tutorial you're about to watch shows you how to make the base pages. There are three styles. You'll need to make two of each style. And I show you how to make the hinge and the book, but I don't show the putting of the pages on the hinges. So watch it through all the way through. Feel free to ask me any questions. Feel free to use this tutorial and make your own. In the crafting world, to me, it's all about sharing. So help yourself, sit back, watch it, and then please make an album and show me what you've done. Enjoy. All right, this tutorial is going to show you how to make the base pages for Portrait of a Lady, the album. And so I thought I would show you what the base pages look like without being covered with the decorative paper. And I'm going to give you the measurements and the score lines, and hopefully that'll make more sense when you see it without the decorative paper on there. So when you first open your book, this is my page one. And there are two separate pockets on the front that are shorter. There's a pocket here and a pocket here. There's also a longer pocket along the right-hand side. When you turn it the page, you will have a flap, okay? There are two pockets on that flap. This pocket goes all the way down, and then there's this shorter pocket down here. When you open up the left-hand side, you're going to have a small pocket to hold things. And when you open up the right-hand flap, you have that same pocket that's going to hold things, okay? And then I'm going to probably, this will be empty just with decorative paper so that you can place your photos on there and they can be the focal point, okay? So this will be page one. This is the side that has the opening that will attach to the binding, okay? So let's go ahead and get started on our measurements of our paper. The very first thing you'll probably want to cut is your 9x12 base piece of paper. It's 9 inches by 12 inches. Put your paper on the 12 inch side on your scoreboard, and I want you to score at 7 inches. Okay. I apologize that that's not as clear as it should be. Okay, so when you score it and then you burnish it, you're gonna have this as your base page, and that's why when you turn it over, that's how you get that flap, okay? So the next thing we're going to do is we're going to make this pocket that was right here, and that's also what's going to make the opening for the hinge. So the next piece of paper you're going to need is going to be a 6x10 sheet of paper, and you're going to place the piece of paper on the 10 inch side on your scoreboard, so the 10 inches across the top, and you're going to score it 1/2 inch and 9.5 inches. So score at 1/2 inch and 9.5. Burnish those, okay? And that's your second piece that you're going to need. Next, we're going to make the two pockets on the front. Those, you're gonna need two pieces of paper by 5.5 by 5. You see that? That's 5.5 by 5, okay? And you're going to place the 5.5 inch side across your scoreboard, and you're going to score at 1/2 inch and 5 inches. That is really a bad picture. Sorry. 1.5. Maybe if I bring it closer, I don't know. Let me focus a little bit. Hold on. See if that made a difference. Yes, it did. Okay, so 5.5 by 5. Put the 5.5 inch side at the top of your scoreboard and score at 1/2 inch and 5 inches. Turn your paper so that the 5 inch side is along the top of your scoreboard and score at 1/2 inch. Okay, so let me show you. You need two of those. So that's what it'll look like. I have, so it's scored on three sides. Now I am going to go ahead and I'm going to put my decorative punch and cut the tops so that they have, and I'm going to just place it in the middle. That's how I get started. So it's the 5.5 inch side that's at the top, the one that has the score lines on either side. And then I'm just going to bring that over, line it up. And it's okay that I'm not going all the way to the side because this is a score. And so that will end up being cut off. And then I need to do it one more time. Moved on me. Oh, looks like I have to do it one more time. Okay. So do that on both of the pockets. Go through and do your decorative punch. Again, it was a 5.5 by 5 piece. We've scored it on three sides. The side that's 5.5 gets the 1/2 inch and the 5 inch score. I'm going to place that in my Martha Stewart punch here. I'm going to center it, and then I'll move it down to finish the punching. Again, it's okay that that doesn't go all the way because that'll be cut off. And there we go. Okay, so I'm going to put that to the side for right now and get rid of my trash here. Okay, a little message from the husband. He's going to be late because he's going to church. Okay, sorry about that. Maybe I should put it on mute. Okay, so then we need the... We're going to need a piece of 5.5 by 9 paper. This is going to make a flap. And you're going to place the 5.5 inch side in your scoreboard. And you're going to score at 1/2 inch. 5.5 by 9, put the 5.5 inch along the top and score at 1/2 inch. Now, we're eventually going to put score tape on this, and normally you would put score tape right here. We're going to end up putting score tape on the inside, just so a little heads up, okay? There's that. So this is actually, that 5.5 by 9 is this flap right here on the right, okay? You are going to need 2 pieces of 3 by 10. These are going to make the long pockets when you open up the inside flaps. So 2 of them at 3 by 10. You're going to place the 3 inch side in the top of your scoreboard. I guess I should do it that way. And you're going to score at 1/2 inch. You're going to turn it on the 10 inch side and score at 1/2 inch and 9.5 inches. Okay, so you'll have 3 sides that have that. And you do that twice. So I have a second one here, 3 by 10, scored it on 3 sides. Put it on the 3 inch side, score at 1/2 inch, place it on the 10 inch side, and you're going to score at 1/2 inch and 9.5 inches. There's 2 more pieces that we need for this base page, and that is for these 2 pockets. Okay, we've already done the inside. And so you're going to need 2 pieces that are 4.5 by 6. Okay, here's a 4.5 by 6. You're going to place the 4 inch side in your scoreboard and you're going to score at 1/2 inch. Then you're going to turn it to the 6 inch side and score it at 1/2 and 5.5. Okay, so I'll let you take a look at that. This will actually be the bottom pocket down here. That's this one because we've scored at the bottom. That's the one that's going to be at the bottom. And so I'm going to go ahead and do my decorative punch. Place. I always start in the middle. Okay, that's fine because it did go past the score line, so I don't have to go all the way to the end. And then I'm going to do the same thing on the other side. And I'll have to do one more for that one. And there it goes. Okay. That was 4.5 by 6. And then we have another 4.5 by 6, but this one we're going to score differently so that our pocket goes all the way to the bottom so we can put longer tags or what have you in there. So you, this is 4.5 by 6, but you're just going to place the 6-inch side on your scoreboard. So 6 inches across the top, and you're going to score at 1/2 inch and 5.5 inches. And then as you always burnish afterwards. Now this will be the top pocket. That's going to be up here. Oops, sorry, up here. And so we don't want to do anything on the bottom so that that goes all the way through. So I'm going to go ahead and just score it on those two sides, and then I'm going to do my decorative punch on the top. Okay, start in the middle, and you know, you don't have to do the decorative punch. You can choose to do whatever you prefer. Okay, that went over the score line, so that one's good. And nope, gotta do one more. Let's back it up right there. You can't see. Okay. Okay. And that's all you need for the first base page. So those are all the pieces you need, all the scoring. So now I'm going to stop and put some of my score tape on the 4.5 by 6. I'm going to put score tape on each of these sides. I am going to miter my corners just because I think it gives it a nicer finish. Okay, so I'll put score tape here and here, and then I'm going to cut at an angle, and I'll show you that what it looks like when it's done. On this one, I'm going to put score tape on the three sides, and then I like to go in, you know, I'll put score tape on, and then I'll come back and show you how I cut out the corners. But on all of these, you're just going to put score tape on those wherever you did the scores, okay? There was only one that we have to do differently, because on all these, you just put the score tape on wherever you folded it down. It's going to go on the outside, except for the 5.5 by 9. On this one, remember, we're going to put our score tape on the inside. So instead of putting it out here on the outside, you're going to put it on the inside. Okay, so I am going to put score tape on, and then I will come back and show you how to put the base page together. Okay, time to put the pages together. I'm going to start with the 9 by 12. Where you folded it should be on the right hand side. Okay, I'm going to place that down on my workspace. I'm going to take the 6 by 10 that I and I put the tape on the outside. I was using the 3/8 score tape, the 3/8 inch. I am going to miter all my corners just to make sure that when I place it, it fits nice and snug the way it's supposed to. And let me do this one. So when I say miter, I'm just talking about cutting off like a little triangle on the corner so you can see that they're just like little pieces chopped off there. So remember, when you put your score tape on, you need to make sure that you have given it a good burnishing so that it stays adhered to your paper. I am going to end up putting these on this on the side here. You're going to line it up on the left. And that's going to be what makes the opening for the hinge. So I'm just going to take off one of my pieces of score tape first, and I'm going to lay it on the bottom, lining it up at the left and on the bottom. Okay, I'm going to push that down real good. I'm going to go ahead and turn this around just so it's easier for me to work with. I'm now going to take off this piece of tape, and I'm going to line it up at the bottom and on the side here. Okay, now you probably want to burnish it just so that it stays real nice. I'm using a Teflon score tool. Okay, so let me turn this back around so that the opening is on the left. We have one pocket here, and then the flap, remember, is on our right. So we're next going to adhere the two pockets that go side by side. So you're going to need your 5.5 by 5 pieces. Okay, we've put score tape on three sides. This is what I'm going to do for making this lay nice. I have a square here where the score lines overlapped, and I'm going to cut kind of at an angle. So cut some bulk out of there. Okay, so you can see I did a little bit at an angle, and I'll do that over here on this side. Okay. And now I need to fix the top. So what I do is I go to that score line and I'm going to cut down to where it meets the other score line. And then I'm going to cut at an angle. Okay. So that when it's closed, it's like that. Okay. And I'm going to do the same thing. I'm going to cut down on the score line down to that very first right here, and then I'm going to cut at an angle. Oh, I'm going to cut just a hair more. Okay, all right, so that when you fold it, looks like that. This is going to go here, and I just want to make sure that everything lines up. So I'm just going to kind of lay this down and see if my measurements were accurate. They better be accurate, right? And let's see. Yep. Okay. So I'm going to, I put the two sides together and then the bottom I put on top of those so that when you slide things in, it goes in easier. So take off the two side pieces. And push them in and then place that bottom on top of it. And take off your third piece of score tape. Okay, so I'm going to turn this sideways so it's easier for me to adhere. The opening is over here. I'm going to turn that so that it's facing me. I'm going to line this up with the bottom and the right hand side. And I'm not going to push down until I know everything's lined up. Okay. I'm going to go ahead and take my burnishing tool here. Okay. See? So that's the bottom. And now we're going to place this second piece at the next to it. So let me trim, miter my corners. I just go a little bit on the outside of each of the score marks. And I'm going to cut down on that score mark on my punch where I made it, and I'm going to angle it. Cut down on the score line, angle it. Okay, starting to get a little messy here. Okay, so once again, I'm going to push my two flaps in first, take the adhesive strip off. I have nails, so I don't usually use a lot of people use a tool to get the sticky, the tape off. Okay, two sides in, bring up the bottom, and then we can take off the sticky there. Okay, so once again, I'm going to turn this sideways so it's easier for me to put on. I'm going to line this up at the bottom and on the right hand side. They should butt up right next to each other. Okay, love it when it works out. I'm going to give it a nice burnishing, make sure it's on there real good. And that is the front side. Two pockets, third pockets. Now we're going to flip it over, okay? And let's go ahead and do the two pockets on the outside first. Let's take care of all of our pockets. So we're going to start with the one that we did not score at the bottom. And we're going to bring it down about an inch and a half from the top. Okay, now you can measure it or you can just eyeball it. I think I'm just going to eyeball it. I just want to make sure that they overlap a little bit. Okay, so I'm going to fix my corner. So cut down on the score line, angle your cut, cut down on that decorative part, angle, and I'm going to go ahead and do the bottom too. Okay, so the bottoms are mitered, tops are mitered. Okay, so again, you're going to bring it down about an inch and a half from the top, and it's on the flap that we're working on. Okay, so I'm going to bring this down so you can see it. Like I said, you can measure it if you want. As long as you have a little bit of overlap between these two, you're good. So let's see. I probably need to bring it down here. Okay, so I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to take off one piece first. And I did the side I didn't want to do first, but okay. And I'm going to go ahead and adhere that one piece about an inch and a half to 2 inches down. I'm going to actually open this. To me, that's going to be easier to line it up at the edge. Okay, and now this should, yeah, it does perfect. Take off this backing over here, and it should go right up to that crease. Okay, so we have the top part done. And now we're just going to put the other piece on top of it. Let me get the corners ready. Angle, 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 angle. Cut that extra little piece off on the decorative punch side and angle. Cut down on the score. Okay, so I'm going to do the two sides first. So I'll take off the score tape on the sides. I'm going to push those together and bring up the bottom flap. And take off the backing. Come on, there we go. Okay. So now we want to line it up at the bottom, making sure. Fabulous. And I'm going to score that. Okay, so now you can see why this pocket goes all the way down, because we didn't do anything to the bottom, and then this one had the stop at the bottom. Okay. So we're almost done with page. This is going to be, you make two of these. I guess I didn't say that before. There's going to be two just like this. So this will be page one and page four, because I like to do the three and then another set of three. Let me get rid of my garbage here. Okay, so now we're ready to do the inside. I'm going to go ahead and put in the flap. So remember, we had the 5x9 piece. I said don't put score tape on the outside, put it on the inside. I am going to miter my corners at an angle. Okay. Now we are going to place this. This was where the hinge is. This is where the hinge is going to go. So that's facing up to me. So the reason why we put it, the tape on the inside, is because we're going to place this inside here, and it's just going to adhere, and so you'll still have that opening. Okay, I hope that makes sense. Okay, all right. So I know that people say just take a little bit off at a time. I just can't get used to it. I just take the whole thing off, and if it's crooked, I get mad, but I've tried doing it where I take a little bit of the tape off at a time, and it just doesn't work well for me. So I'm going to place this inside. I'm going to scoot it up as far as I can. I'm going to make sure it folds over and it lines up, and then I'm going to press down. Okay, so now we have two flaps. And we still have the opening for our hinge. Okay, remember there's two pockets that go here. We are gonna, I'm gonna show you where to put magnets too. I'm gonna put magnets on. So let's go ahead and do the last two pockets. Miter your corners, bottom and at the top. I think it looks better. A little bit outside of each of those score marks. So there we go. Okay. And you don't want to put it right on the score line, because then when you fold it, it will be too stiff, or there's going to be some interference. So I like to butt it up close to the score line, but not on top of the score line. Okay. So once again, I'm going to take my side pieces off first. Okay. I'm going to fold those in and bring up the bottom. Okay. Now I'm going to turn this so that it's easier for me to put on. I'm working with the left-hand side, but I'm going to turn it so that the left-hand side is at the top. Okay. So that I can place it easier. Take off that last piece, butt it up close to the score line, but don't put it on the score line. Make sure it goes to the sides. Okay, and give it a good burnish. I have a little bit of a ripple in mine. That should be all right. See, I have a little bit of a ripple. Okay, so now we're going to put the second pocket on the inside flap. Miter. Even the top piece. Nope, I didn't get that very good. And the bottom. Okay. Do the two sides first by taking off the adhesive strip. Fold those two in and bring up the bottom. Okay, so I'm working with the right hand flap, but I'm going to place that at the top so it's easy for me to put it on. And just like I said before, don't put it right on that score line, put it a hair above. Okay, right above it. Okay, and that one lays much flatter. I did that one better. Okay, so this will go in and this will go here. So I'm going to want magnets. I don't have the size right with me that I want, so I'm just going to have you label where you should put your magnets. Okay, so let me get... Okay, so we're on the back side where we had the flap. I want you to place a magnet here on the left-hand side. And then with the right-hand side closed, you want the magnet to meet on that flap. So you want the other magnet to be here. So please, I put a circle and the word magnet on the left-hand side, and then where it closes on that other flap, I'm going to remember to put a magnet here before I put my decorative paper on. Okay, so that is page style one. Okay, and you should have two of those when you're done. And I am really unhappy about this pucker, but maybe it'll be fine. I don't know. Okay, so I have two of those done. And now I'm going to start talking about the second style. And I'll give you the measurements. Let me clean up my extra mess here. Okay, so let me remind you of what page style 2 is going to look like. This is the opening for the hinge. So we have a shorter page with a the decorative border. You open it up. I have a tag and I have another little page just like the front, and then I have a larger page. When I turn that over, I have two flaps that, and then a pocket on the inside. Okay. Did I cut 5x8? I hope I cut that. Hold on, I'm checking to make sure I cut everything the way I was supposed to. 5x8. Do I have a 5x8? I don't remember cutting that. That's why I'm... Oh, maybe I did. Yep, I did. Okay. All right, so let's get ready for page style 2. So I'll give you the measurements and the scoring directions. And so let's start with our base page. You're going to need a 7x9. No scoring on this one. You are going to need a 7x10 with your 10-inch side on the top of your score board. You're going to score at 1/2 inch and 9.5 inches. Okay, and burnish the sides wherever you score. Okay, you are going to need a 6x12 sheet, so it's 6x12. You're going to place the 12-inch side along the top of your score board, and you're going to score it in half, so at the 6-inch mark. Okay, score it so that it's a 6x6 square now, but it opens. Okay, for the tag, I cut a piece of 7.5x4. I went ahead and took my corner chomper thingamabob and did the corners at two of the tops. And I took my hole punch and punched a hole in the center to make it look like a tag. That was 7.5x4. And we're not going to score anything on that. We need a little hinge. And so I cut a piece that was 2x4. 2 inches by 4 inches. You're going to place the 2-inch side on your scoreboard and score at 1 inch. So right in half. Okay. You'll have two flaps. So you'll need two of these. They're 4.5x6. 4.5x6. You're going to place the 6-inch side in your scoreboard and score at 5.5. Okay, now this is one of those where we're going to end up putting the tape on the inside also. Okay, so normally we would put it out here, but this time we're going to put it on the inside. You need two of those. Well, actually you would want four because you're making two of these pages. Okay, so what I'm telling you to cut, you're actually going to want to do double. Okay, and there's my second 4.5x6. I placed the 6-inch in the scoreboard. Scored at 5.5. Remember, when we put tape on, we're not going to put it on the outside. We're going to put it on the inside. Okay. And one last piece, 5x8. This will be a pocket. When you place the 5-inch side on your scoreboard, score it a half. So 5 inches on the top of your scoreboard, score it a half. Turn it so that you have 8 inches. And score at 1/2 inch and 7.5 inches. Okay. And so once again, I'm going to go and put my tape on, and I am going to go ahead and miter my corners like I did before, so I can not, I'm not going to bore you by showing you the cutting this time. Remember on these two pieces, 4.5x6 that we made where we chomped off the corners, do not put the tape on the outside, put the tape on the inside. Okay? I will be back. Okay, so let's go ahead and put the pages together for the second style. I'm using the 7x9 piece as the base, and then I'm taking the 7x10, and that I already put the score tape on the sides and I mitered the corners. I'm gonna go ahead and do one, take off one piece at a time and line it up. So I'm gonna start at the bottom, and I want to make sure it's lined up along the bottoms and the side. Okay. And then I'm gonna go ahead and turn it upside down so it's easier for me to work with, and I'll take off that second piece. And I want to make sure. Okay, good. Everything lined up great. So we have an opening on each side. This style does have the side pocket too on the outside. So if you want to put a large matted tag in there, you can. So the next thing we're going to do is we're going to apply a hinge. So this was the 2x4, and then we scored it at 1 inch and folded it in half. So I went ahead and put score tape on one side. Okay. Before I attach it to the page, I need to take my 6x12, and I already went ahead and did my decorative punch, and I am going to line up. Let me move this. I'm going to line up my hinge where I think I want it. So like I have about an inch of overhang on each, on the top of the hinge and at the bottom of the hinge, because this is a 4-inch hinge and this was a 6-inch piece of paper. So I have an inch at the top and the bottom. And I just took a pencil and I put a little mark at the top and a little mark at the bottom. Okay. So that shows me how long the hinge is. So then I got my ruler and I got an X-Acto knife and I lined it up and I cut on the fold from one of the lines to the other. Okay. So what that does is it allows for the hinge. Let me put it through here. Make sure it's okay. So that's going to allow for a hinge to go through there. And then we're going to end up adhering this to the top so that it doesn't come off. Okay. So that's the mechanism we're going to do next. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to take my hinge back out. I'm going to go to my base page and I'm going to place the hinge on the edge. I'm going to eyeball it about where I want it. I kind of want to center it. So I'm going to take off my backing of my score tape. Make sure there's no overhang of that tape. Okay, again, I'm just going to eyeball it. And I'll press down. Okay, so you can see that it has, that makes a hinge. So what I'll do next is I'll put, I already punched each side. I'm going to place that hinge through the cut that we made. Okay, and so we have this, but we want to make sure, line it up right, we want to make sure that this doesn't come off. So that's what we're going to do next, is adhere this tag to the top part. Okay, so I'm going to go ahead and put score tape now on the top of the hinge right here, and I use the 3/8 score tape. So I'll probably be able to put two on here. Want good coverage. Okay. And again, you're going to eyeball it and try and center the tag. Come on. There we go. Okay, so I kind of want it peeking out the top. And a little bit on the bottom. Okay, so that's how we get that look. smaller pages. And so we'll cover that with decorative paper. Okay. This will leave open for, you know, larger, put a couple pictures on there. So now the back, I'm going to close it. I'm working on the back now. We have our 5x8. I took my punch and I went ahead and did my decorative trim. I do need to cut the corners here at the top. I overlooked that. And okay. And we're going to place this down at the bottom, like so. So I'm going to go ahead and do my side pieces first. Push those down and bring the bottom up. Take off that third strip. And I'm going to line it up along the bottom and the side. Love it when it lines up. And I'll take my burnishing tool, my bone folder, and make sure it's adhered real good. Okay, throw away some of my scraps here. And like I said, you can make a tag to put in here. I didn't give you the measurements for that piece of paper, but you can go ahead and do that one on your own. So then there are two flaps that we're going to adhere. And they're going to go over like so. Okay, they're going to be like that. Now, I am going to want magnets on mine. And so I'm going to write myself a note so that before I cover, I'm going to want a magnet here. So I'll put a circle and write magnet. And then wherever that closes and meets, I'm going to want a magnet to match it over here on this page. So I'm going to go ahead and write the word magnet where I think it'll line up. And I'll do that with the second page too. Put magnet so I don't forget. And then there's going to be a magnet probably about right here. Okay. All right. So I'm going to go ahead and do one at a time. I did put the tape on the inside of the flap and I did miter the corners. I'm going to line it up at the bottom. And I want to get it just right. I'm going to fold it to make sure. And I'll push down. And where'd I put the, there it is. Okay, and one more. I'm going to turn this one sideways just so it's easier for me to put in. And I'm going to want to make sure that it goes all the way to the edge. Good, it does. Okay. Off. Okay, remember there's an opening here, so you don't want to put it on the back, you're putting it on the inside. Line it up. And you want to make sure that it lines up. And that would be page style two. And again, we would put the magnets on. I don't have the right size right now, so. And that's the second style. And again, you're doing that twice so that you have two of them. So there's those. So this would be page two and page five. Page two and five, okay? So we have four pages done. So it's gonna go page one, page two, now I'll do page three, and then page one and page two again. Now I'm going to show you how I did the third style. There might be an easier way to do this. There probably is, and I probably am making it harder than it needs to be. So I'm going to show you how I did it. If you can think of an easier way, go for it by all means. I would, yeah, I just kind of did it by trial and error. So we are going to start with, what are we going to start with? The 7x10. Okay, 7x10. And what else do I want? I want the, yeah, I want the 7.5x10. This is the one that we scored on three sides. Okay, so I'm going to go ahead and put tape on the three sides. And as I'm telling you how to do this, I'm trying to remember myself. So make sure you watch this video all the way through to make sure I didn't make any stupid mistakes. Okay, and you know what? I'm going to end up cutting, so I'm not going to put tape all the way across, because I don't want to waste it, because we're going to end up cutting this at an angle. So I'm not going to put all that tape down there. However, on the bottom, you will need to go all the way to the end, because the bottom doesn't get cut. Okay. Okay, go ahead and do the mitering of the corner. And the mitering up here too. Okay. And so this is going to go on this is the front page. Now, what I did was I made a tick mark as to how far over I wanted to go. And I need to look at my original page to see. So I went 2¼. So I'm going to measure 2¼, starting at the score line. I'm going to measure 2¼, and I'm going to put a little tick mark. So, about right here. Okay. And then at the bottom, I went up and measured up about 3¾. So now I'm going to turn my paper on the side that does not have any scoring, and I'm going to measure starting at this, the bottom score line. I'm going to put a tick mark at 3¼. Okay, and so what I'm going to do is I'm going to cut from one of those tick marks to the other. Okay, so I'm just going to put this in my trimmer real quick and cut this. So bear with me. From one tick mark to the other. Okay, so now it looks like this. And now I can adhere it to my page. Okay, so I'm going to line it up down at the bottom. Okay, take off my score tape. And I'm just going to do all three sides. I'm going to go ahead and put the bottom in. Now I'm going to put the side in first. And bring up the bottom piece. Bring down that top piece. Okay, and now we're going to line this puppy up down at the bottom. And I want to make sure that I get it on the side. Okay, and I'm going to go ahead and burnish it and make sure it's adhered real good. I'm doing the opposite of what I did before. On this page, I made this one the binding. Opening the binding. So I have to do the, I did it just reverse this. It'll still work. Okay. So there's one side. Let's go ahead and put our pocket on. So let's grab a 4x8. I'm going to go ahead and do my decorative punch. Starting in the center. Other side. Okay, got that. I go ahead and put my scorch tape around the edges and the three sides. And third one. Oop, out of scorch tape on this bad boy. I have more. Go back to this roll. Okay. Make sure your score tape's on real good. Here we go with the corners again. Now remember on this one, you cut down on that little score line to make sure that you get rid of this extra piece. Okay. And I'm gonna cut down on this little score line and miter the corner. I don't like this little piece that's hanging out, so I'm gonna trim that. Okay. Do the corners at an angle on each of the squares. Okay. And now let's adhere our pocket. Okay. We're going to do line it up just right here at the bottom. Fabulous. Easy. Taking off our score tape on the sides. Bring up the bottom and then take off the score tape on that one. Okay, line it up, bottom and sides. Perfect. And see, with my decorative punch, it goes right to the edge where we cut it. So that's exactly the way I wanted it. Okay, so remember, we don't have anything to adhere it to our binding yet. So the next piece is going to have to do that. I hope I did this right. I don't think I did. So give me a second to think about this. What did I need to do? So if I turn it over, I need the binding on this side. So I'm actually going to What did I do wrong? Okay, give me a second. So I want this open. So I'm gonna make the, I'm gonna trim this off. Is that what I need to do? So I need the opening on this side. Yep, okay. So this was 10 by 8. I'm gonna cut off the one side so that it will be open. So I'm going to cut off the right hand side so that it's actually 7.5 instead of 8. So let me do that real quick. I don't know how I got screwed up. Okay, so now we just have the three sides. Huh. Okay, I'm still baffled at how that happened. So I'm going to go ahead and put score tape on the bottom. Now we're not going to have all of this, so I'm not going to put score tape all the way up. I don't want to waste all of it. And I'm not going to have it all the way across. I'll just put it about halfway. Okay. So here's what you need to do. I'm going to fold these in, even with the tape still on, so that I can see. And I'm going to look at the other side, and I'm going to make a tick mark as to where, I mean, it was 2 1/4 and 3 1/4. You can do, if you want it to be perfect, you can use, you know, at this as a guide. I'm going to go ahead and just use my ruler. But you want to measure from the right going in to the right to left. So I need a 2 1/4. So I'm going to line this up at the right-hand side of my paper. and I'm going to put a tick mark. Okay, and then remember we did 3 1/4, so starting at the score line. Don't go all the way to the bottom, start at the score line. And I'm going to measure up 3 1/4, and I'm going to put a tick mark. Okay, so I'm going to put it in my trimmer, and I'm going to cut from this tick mark to this tick mark, and I'm just going to take the trimmer and slice it. Okay, so now we have that. So the cut is on the left. So when I adhere this now, this will be open. I'm not putting any tape on the right hand side, so that'll make my hinge. So I'm going to go ahead and cut out the corner on this side and this side. One of these days I'll become one of those crafters who never makes a mistake. I don't know when that'll happen, but maybe one day. Okay. Yes, this is what I need to do. Okay. So now I'm going to adhere this. I'm going to take off the sticky, the backing. And here. Okay, and I'm going to lay this down, line it up at the bottom so that the opening will be on the right hand side. And now I'm going to come to the top. I'm turning it upside down so it's easier. Take off that little piece and adhere that. All right. Now we have a hinge. So it will be, we have the hinge. Okay. There's always a way to fix it, right? Okay. Just confused me. I didn't know what I had done wrong. Okay, so now we just need to adhere the pocket. I'm going to go ahead and take my decorative punch again, line it up in the center, move her down, and the other side. Oh, oopsie, look at that. That won't work. Gotta put it in one more time. There we go. Clean up my mess. Time to put the score tape on the three sides. Last pocket. Go ahead and miter your corners. Go ahead and take care of the top by cutting down on that score line and then at an angle. Down on the score line. Cut at an angle. Don't like that little piece hanging off the edge, and trim. Okay, take that piece. We're going to go ahead and do the sides first, and then we'll bring up the bottom to attach. Bring that up. Take off the third side, line it up. Line it up at the bottom and on the sides. And it lines up fabulously. And that is our third style and the last style. So this has 6 pages. Now, I'm not one who shows you how to go back and mat and decorate, but you can look through the walkthrough and see how I did it and see if you want to copy anything like that. The only thing you're going to have to do now, I'll probably come back and show you how to make the hinge. So page style 1, then page style 2, page style 3, and then repeat 1, 2, and 3. Okay, so I'm probably going to do at least a 3-inch, at least a 3-inch. Let's see. My binding will probably be, oopsie. Now don't forget, you have to go back and put your magnets on. I can't show you that because I don't have any right now. Yeah, I'm probably going to do to 3 to, you know what, I might even do a 3.5-inch binding. Let's make this puppy fat. Yeah, I'm going to play it safe. I'm going to do a 3.5-inch binding. So what I'm going to need is my chipboard, and I'll get that here in a second, but let me have you get it ready too. Let's get a piece of paper. So you're going to need 3 pieces. This is going to be 3.5 by, I don't remember how tall it was, hold on. It's 9 inches, so we're going to go 9.5. So 3.5 by 9.5. Okay. That's going to be one of the pieces of chipboard. And the other ones will be 7.5 by 9.5. So I'll get mine cut and I'll get the materials ready for the binding. So 7.5, 2 at 7.5 by 9.5 for the front and the back, and the spine's going to be 3.5 by 9.5, and this is for your chipboard. Okay, for the hinges, we're going to need the full 12 inches across, and we're going to go 8 7/8. Let's see. Our pages are 9. I'm going to, I'm going to go 8 7/8. So the binding, the paper for the hinge will be, okay, I just forgot what I was going to say. Oh, I just forgot what I just said. Ridiculous. I got to know this way. I think I said 8 7/8. I might. Yeah, I'll do 8 7/8. 8 7/8 by 12. You're going to need a piece of cardstock for your hinge that's 8 7/8 by 12. Okay, so I'll get all my stuff cut and then I will show you how to make the hinge. We'll be back. All right, I'm going to show you how to do the scoring for the hinge. Remember, you needed a 12 inch by 8 7/8 inch. We're going to put the 12 inch across the top. I went ahead and pre-scored mine just so I could make sure that I had it right. So what you're going to do is you're going to start by scoring at the 1 3/4 inch. So go to 1 3/4 and score all the way down to the bottom. After you do the 1 3/4, you're going to go every half inch. You're just going to keep doing half inches until you get to 10 1/4 is your last score. So you started with 1 3/4, then you're going to go to 2 1/4, then 2 3/4, then 3 1/4, then 3 3/4. You keep going a half inch. Your very last score is going to be on 10 1/4. Okay, I hope that makes sense. Start at 1 3/4, score at a half inch until you and then your last one's at 10 1/4. Okay, so then what I like to do, just because I like to put HHS. So the first 2 1/2 inches are my hinge, the next one is the space, the next 2 are my hinge, and then I have a space. So you're going to have to now burnish your scores so that you have mountain peaks. And see? Okay. So the first one is a hinge. So you score it so that you have 1. The next one's going to be a space. You take the next 2 halves, score them. That's going to be your second. Then you have a space. Then you score. The next 2 are a hinge, then a space. The next 2 a hinge, then a space. next to a hinge, then a space, and then the next two are a hinge. So now what we have to do is put tape on one side so that it attaches to the second side. Okay, and I'm also going to, let's see, how do I want to do this? I'm going to do I'll do the second half inch and the third half inch, skip, second, third. That's what I'm going to do. Okay, here we go. On the back, I'm not going to put a piece of score tape on the first half inch. I'm going to start at the second half inch. And oh, my lighting is terrible. Okay, I'm going to put it at the second, and I'm going to put it at the third. And you'll see why I do that. If you haven't made one before, you'll know why. I mean, I'll show you. So then we're going to skip, and we're going to put two more pieces. Okay, so skip one and then do two. And there are other tutorials out there for hinges. So if this is not clear enough, please visit another and see if you can find one that makes more sense. Tammy Merrill has some. NW Lady, I don't remember the numbers after her name. I'll have to get, I'll look at that. And she has a great tutorial too. So skip, do this, do then do two. Skip, then do two. Skip, then do two. And I'm going to do skip and then just do one. Okay. So what we're going to do is our hinges, and then the tape that we don't take off is going to help it us attach it to the spine. So I'm going to take off the first piece, and I'm going to pinch those together, and there's my first hinge. See, on the other side, there's my first hinge. I'm not going to take this tape off. I'm going to take the next piece off. And I'm going to pinch those together, and you'll see that that makes a second hinge. Hinge, space, hinge. I'm not going to take this tape off. I'm going to go to the next one. Pinch together to make your hinge. So where are we at here? So now we have three hinges. Okay, I'm not going to take this tape off. I'm going to take the next one off. Pinch it together to make the hinge. Sorry, I'm out of camera. Now we have four hinges. Flip it back over onto the back. Go to the first piece of tape after the space. Fold it over and squeeze it to make the hinge. So now we have five, and we have one more. Take off the last piece of tape. Okay, so there are our six hinges. Now we cut our spine out of chipboard, and that should have been 3.5 by 9.5. So I'm just going to double check. Yep, that works. That's going to fit on there just fine. Okay. Yep. Okay. So the reason now we have tape here, we're just going to have to add tape here and here so that when we're ready to do our, adhere it to our spine, it'll lay down nice. Some people fold it around so that it's, you know, they get rid of the flaps. I'm going to go ahead and keep my flaps this time and adhere them to the other on the sides. So here will be our next step. I have my chipboard. And I'm going to end up wrapping it. Okay. Two of these, 7.5 by 9.5. This was 3.5 by 9.5. I'm going to take two pieces of my cardstock and tape it together so it's long. And then I'm going to wrap my chipboard. And then I'll be able to place my hinge on. And then we'll go to decorating the pages and putting them on the hinges. So I don't walk you through the matting, just, you know, measure, and always, a lot of people mat either 1/8 or 1/4 inch smaller than what they measured the cardstock to be. So if I measured this, and my ruler is where? Oh, right here. So because this is 9 inches, when I go to mat, I will either cut it at 8 3/4, or I could go, it depends how, I'll probably go 8 3/4. So I'll just take a fourth off, okay? So measure it and always go 1/4 inch less for your matting. And like I said, if you want, you can take a look at my final walkthrough to help you on your decorating, if you want to model it after mine or whatever, so. Okay, so the only thing I'll show you when I come back is just how to wrap the chipboard. So I'll be back. Okay, folks, the last thing I need to show you is about covering your the cover and the hinge. So we did the hinge together. I went ahead and finished putting score tape on the back, and then I put a piece of score tape on each side of the hinge, on every single one. Okay, so you have 12 pieces because there's 6 hinges, and you're putting a piece on each side, because then when you you can take both sides off then, and you'll place your page on there. So you'll attach them like that. Okay, so let's get started on this part. I took two pieces of 12 by 12 and I adhered them together because one wasn't long enough for our book. And I did trim it down a little bit. I ended up cutting it so that it was 11.5 inches tall. 11.5, okay? And then I went ahead and took the 12 and 12, and I ended up cutting a little bit off the end because I wouldn't need that much for what I'm, for the covers we're doing. Okay, the next thing I did was I took my 7.5. Oh, the next thing I did was I put a 1-inch border with pencil around the edge just to help me keep everything lined up so I don't get off when I'm putting my chipboard on. So I just took a ruler and a pencil and measured a 1-inch down each side. I took my 7.5 by 9.5 piece chipboard and I put score tape on it. And I'm going to place that, I'm going to take the tape backing off, I'm going to place that there. I'm then going to put a piece of 1/4 inch score tape down next to it. And then I'll place my spine. That'll make a good spacing for it. Then I'll put another piece of 1/4 inch score tape next to it as for a spacer. And then I will place my last piece of 7.5 by 9.5 down. I'll end up putting more tape on. This takes a ton of tape, this part does. So have plenty of score tape on hand. All right, so let's start. I'm going to, this is monotonous. I burnished the tape, I hope, well enough so that when I pull the backing off, I don't get the tape coming off with it. So when you use this much tape, that's why the sheets of score tape are really nice. Like I just put 1 6x6 in the center. Tammy at Country Craft Creations does sell different size score tape pieces. And so I found that it is worth the time to buy some of those bigger sheets, because this is monotonous. Okay. See, look, oh, one big piece. That's so nice. All right, so now I'm going to line it up at my 1-inch so that I keep it straight. And that looks good. And I'm going to press it down real firm. Okay. Now, I am going to use that 1/4 inch score tape as a spacer. I've just always been told that you are supposed to put that there. I think it helps with your paper laying smooth too when you bend it. I don't know. Now I gotta find, oh, there it is. Okay, so now I'm gonna place a piece of score tape right up against, but it right up against this edge. And I'm gonna turn it just so it's easier for me to get it on there, right? Right up against it. And so that helps us place then our next piece, which will go right next to it. We'll butt it up next to it and make sure it's lined up at the top and at the bottom. So I'll go ahead and take off the backing now. Sure, there's no pieces of tape hanging over. We'll push those over. And last one. Okay, make sure that's down real good. Nothing hanging off the edge. Okay, now we line it up, butt it up right up against that tape, and line it up with the lines you drew. Press it down real good. Put another one on this side. Again, I'm going to turn it just so it's easy for me to butt it right up against there. Okay, press down, and now we can line up our last piece of 7.5 by 9.5. It's already, so it'll be right about there. Yep. Okay. Now, being as I'm using the Graphic 45, I'm wrapping it with the Artisan cardstock, the craft color, rather than using the Graphic 45 paper, because when you fold it over, it does have a tendency to crack. So I will just cut out pieces and place them on top of the craft cardstock after I wrap the cover. Okay, no tape hanging over, butt it up right up against that piece of tape and line it up with the lines we drew and give it a firm press. All right, so it's kind of big so you can't see it all at once, but now comes even more tape. Yes, tape, tape, tape. So now we're going to place score tape along the perimeter of the chipboard and the perimeter of the cardstock. When you go to all this work, you want to make sure that you have a good stick and that nothing falls apart after all your hard work. So there's the bottom one on the chipboard, and now I'll place a piece on the bottom of the cardstock. Okay, make sure it's on real good. I'm gonna turn it and do it on the other side also, and then I'll do the two sides. On the chipboard, along the perimeter. Okay, and on the paper. Press it down real good. And now the sides. Turning it sideways. So you'll notice that I have a little bit where I didn't tape because I'm going to be mitering my corners and that's going to come off anyway. So try not to waste. All right. So now we want to kind of give the paper a memory. So we're going to start lifting it up and creasing it. So that it will fold real nice. Where's my... So sometimes I even just take this and start scoring, pushing it with my bone folder. Okay. Do the other side too. And this artisan cardstock does not crack. Sides. Just lifting it up. One more side. So now it's time to miter the corners. Now there's two different ways. And let me find my... Okay. So one way is if you have this tool, it's called the... where'd it go? Perfect trim ruler. And depending on how thick your chipboard is, it shows you how much to cut. I think this is, might actually be a quilter's tool. But you, I think this is one and a, yeah. So I'm going to line it up on the corner and it gives me just a little bit of overhang so that it wraps the corner and you don't see the chipboard. And I'm going to take my X-Acto knife and I'm just going to slice it. I think I need a new blade on my X-Acto knife, to be real honest. Okay. All right. So we have our corner and we're going to do that on all four. Line it up. If you don't have this tool, just make sure when you're mitering the corners, you leave a little bit of overhang. So that you have all of the chipboard covered. You don't want any showing. And I'm just going to finish this with a cut because... There we go. It takes me a while to get used to this too. Sometimes it's hard for me to line it up just right. Okay, miter the corner. A little bit left. And I have one more. Right. Oh, I'm moving it. Hold on. Okay. Okay. That one looks a little close. All right. So now we're going to take off the tape and fold over so that we have a covered cover. Okay. So I'm gonna, I think I wanna do the bottom pieces first. Yeah, I'll do the bottom pieces. So I'm gonna take off these middle. This is when I need, let's see. I have a hook thing. It's hard to get this middle piece of tape out. Hold on, I've got a solution. I just gotta figure out where my tool is. This is one of those Cricut tools. I have a Cricut and never use it. Let's see, is this what I want? Yep. Okay, so I'm just gonna use this tool to help me get the ouch. Yep, that's sharp. Okay, and then I don't want to do the other one so I don't forget. Okay. The rest I should be able to get without using that device. Okay, I'm going to take off piece from the chipboard, and I'm just going to lift this side up just a little bit so it's out of the way. And I'm going to take off this bottom piece, and I'm going to fold it over and stick it down. Kind of give it a firm press in between the chipboard. Okay, I'm going to do the reverse side. Taking the piece off the chipboard, and then I'll go ahead and lift up a little bit on those side pieces just so that they're out of the way. Let's lift up a little bit. Just lift this up a little bit so it's out of the way. Okay, and once again, you know what? Did I take that piece off? Nope, I didn't. So that was dumb. Hold on. I knew it didn't. It wasn't adhering quite right. There we go. Now it should stick. Perfect. Helps if you take the backing off the tape. Burnish so it stays on real good. Give it a crease in between those pieces of chipboard. And now the sides. Okay, I'm lifting it, turning it so it's easier for me to work. So I'm taking off the backing of the tape. I want to make sure that I push in those extra, that little bit of extra that's on the edge there, on the corners. And the last one, making sure I tuck in the corner there, just pushing it in with my nail. Now, I have a hair of a gap right here, but I'm going to cover it with paper. And so here is our book. It's got a quite a bit of a spine here. That's a bigger one. But it folds real easily. And the last thing I'm going to do is put my, we want to center this top and bottom and side to side. Okay. So we got to make sure you give this a good crease so you can see where that spine begins and ends. Okay. And look at all these we get to take off now. I'm not very happy with some of these corners. Sometimes I don't think I use that ruler right. Sometimes it might be easier just to eyeball it and make sure that you're leaving enough of a leftover border when you're mitering the corners for your cover. I don't know. I don't like that. I did that on my last book too. However, I did watch a video that Tammy Merrill did on how to save your corners if you have a mistake. So I may have to do that if it bugs me too much. The good thing is that this is craft, the paper is, and so is, I mean, the color of the chipboard is too, but still, oof, I hate it when it's not exactly right. Okay. Remember, we want to center the hinges on the spine and the top and the bottom. And I'm thinking that looks about right. So I'm going to press down, press in the middle. Make sure it's adhered real good. Take your bone folder and kind of help that seam here so that it'll fold real good. Varnish. All right, that is the cover. And now it's just time to decorate. So, after you do the decorating of your pages and putting the matting down, then you're going to go through and take off the tape that's on the hinges, place the page on there, kind of bend it over so it lays flat. And it'll be fabulous. All right. Let me know if you have any questions. Again, if you want help with the decorating, just look through the walkthrough. Thank you so much. Everything that I used pretty much was from Country Craft Creations. Okay, I want to update you and show you where the progress I've made. I went ahead and matted all of my pages. It's going to be kind of thick, so I'm glad I made a 3.5-inch binding. Just to show you, I went a fourth of an inch smaller. I went ahead and cut some paper for the tags that go in the pockets. I'm running pretty low. Actually, I don't even have any full sheets left of the craft. So I'll show you when I get to the pocket. There, I want to make an insert, so I'm going to have to wait and show that later because I got to order more paper. But so this is what it looks like matted. I went ahead, take these cards out of there, and the only thing I did on this page after matting it was I just added a piece of lace right there just to kind of girly it up a little bit. You know, on the inside you can't really add a whole lot of embellishments because it won't close nicely. This does have the magnet, so there's a magnet over here and on here so that it closes nicely. I added a piece of lace here This came from the 8x8 paper pack, so it wasn't big enough or long enough for my book. So I had to take some of the other paper and I just put a decorative punch on it and added to the top and the bottom. So the back, when you turn the page, oh, actually this is the front, that was the other side. Here are the tags I made to put in these pockets. Right now I've just added a piece of lace right here, or trim. I'll come back and embellish it more. This I can embellish on the outside because I have half inch gussets, so it should be fine. I did add a journaling spot, or not, it's not a tag, whatever it's called. I can't, a mat, whatever, to go in this pocket. I can't think of my words. And I did the decorative punch. Okay. So that was page, that'll probably be my first page of the book. So it'll turn, and we have the flap, open, open. Okay. Another page that I, that we did together, or that we did the base pages for, is the little shorter pieces. The only thing I've done differently so far is to add some flower trim. And I love the perfume bottle paper. Again, I went a fourth of an inch smaller than the page. I do have magnets to keep this closed. So there's a magnet here and then a magnet over here on the other side. Okay, here's the tag matted. And on the other side. Okay, and this will be good. I might add, I have some scraps of my craft, so I might cut out some mats for pictures. And then when you turn it over, I do have magnets on these flaps. Okay, I'll take that out too. I'm not ready for that. I was just seeing what it looked like. I don't know what I'm going to put in this pocket. I'll see if I have a piece of craft paper big enough, but I don't think so. And I don't, so until I get more craft paper, there are two pages where you can put a side piece in for pictures, and I'll have to wait on that too. The third page is matted, and it's just got a pocket here and the pocket here. I'll be adding some of the paper collection pictures as embellishments. This one I can add some dimension to. When you flip it over, there's the other side. It's hard, even if I don't decorate it that much, there's so much pattern, you know, pattern to this paper that makes it beautiful. Anyway, so now we're just on the second batch. Same page styles as before. We did two of each page. So this will be the front. I have another mat on the inside of that pocket. Two pockets here. When you turn it over, pocket, oh, that was dumb. Pocket here and a pocket here. This one goes all the way to the bottom. You gotta be careful with when you do these decorative punches. They're not real durable, so I kind of bent it a little bit. And then when you open it, remember it's magnetized. So pocket, pocket. I'll probably put matte paper here. This is where I want to put some sort of booklet inside these pockets that will hold a lot of pictures. So I'm gonna order more craft, and then I'll probably make some sort of mini album insert. Maybe it'll have, I don't know, a waterfall, or I haven't decided yet, but I wanna get a lot of pictures in here. And this one I wasn't thinking very well because there's too much green and there's not a whole lot of pizzazz. I should have done the ticket a different color, the tag a different color, but it'll work. I'll just have to add something to give it some color. And the back of the tag is the flowers. That's what I probably should have done on the other side. Should have reversed them. Okay, that one's magnet to keep these two flaps together. On this side, these two have magnets. Okay, they flap open, open. And then I did put, this was from the paper collection. It was a little bit short, so I had to add another piece of paper on the edge, and because I really wanted that saying on that pocket. Okay. And last one is same style as the other one, the third page, with a different paper on it. So not only have I matted the pages, I've also been working on the cover. So what I've done so far, I went ahead and glued my hinge system in. If I hadn't already shown you that, I can't remember. I did not do my inside until the very end of putting the paper on the front, and here's why. This is what I'm going to be doing for the front. I'm going to be adding some flowers because I'm a flower girl, and I got to put something on here and some trim. But I wanted to put this doorknob embellishment on here, and so that's a brad, and so I had to poke my hole to put and push the brad through. So that's why I did my front cover first, and then I went on the inside so that it would cover up the brad on the inside. I also have the corner pieces on there for durability, and it looks good. I think it's the same metal tone as the doorknob. So this is picture is matted on one of the peach pieces, and then it's matted on the green in the back. So then the side is peach, and I'm still going to add some embellishments, and then the back is that green. So I will tell you, I ended up purchasing, I used one full pack of the 12x12. I used a couple sheets, not very many, from the 8x8. I did go ahead and order a second pack so that I didn't have to worry so much about running out. Whenever you do these bigger books with more pages and flips and flops and all that kind of flaps, you end up going through a lot more paper. So I went ahead and ordered a second one just to be sure. And I'm sure I'll use pieces of it to decorate. And if not, I'm going to make tags with it anyway. So then I went ahead and put my decorative paper on the front. If you like that doorknob, it's a graphic 45. It comes with another one too. I got this from Tammy's store, Country Craft Creations. She carries these and I love them. I think they look classy. Excuse me. So I did put a decorative, cut a piece from the paper collection and run it along the bottom. Oopsie, sorry. Okay. And then I fussy cut this girl because I think she's beautiful, and I'm going to put her on the side here. Okay. And I've decided, I went ahead and purchased the, the ephemera and journaling cards that came in here. I went ahead and ordered those, and I'm going to do a waterfall, and I'm going to put these, the waterfall here, because it'll fit the calling cards just perfect. Of course, it won't look like this when I'm done, but these I cut 4 1/4 by 3 1/2, and then I scored on the 3 1/2 inch side at 1/2. And so I'm going to be putting, I'll be leaving one side blank so that if I want to write on it, but I thought that'll be cool as a waterfall, and then flip up. So that's where I'm at right now. I will come back and show you how to attach the pages if you don't know. That is one thing I have to work on. I have to remember to be patient and just take a little bit of the backing off of the tape, line it up, and then pull it off. I'm known to take off both sides and then try and stick it on, and I make terrible mistakes. So I'm going to do it right this time. So hope yours is going well. I'll come back. If you don't know how to do the waterfall, I cut a base piece that's 4 1/4 across so that it'll be, I'll just attach all my pieces. Then you lift it up, and where the half inch is adhered to the base, then you're going to line up the next piece. Okay. The next piece will be adhered. Give me a second. Right underneath of it. I'm not doing a very good job of holding it. Sorry. Okay. So then you just butt it up against the other one. And then there'll be stair steps, waterfall. And then I don't know how long I need to trim this. So, okay, so that's where I'm at now. If you have any questions, make sure you let me know. But I'm going to wrap this up pretty quick here, and I'll come back with the final reveal. Actually, I'll probably put the reveal first so you can see what it looks like. All right, thank you.